Yeah, baby.
Oh, man, I wanted you so bad.
Carl, how you feeling?
Horrible, but great. You know, actually, I feel pretty good. You know, I just have some body issues. Feet hurt. Hand feels sore. But, you know, we need to both play us. But, oh, man, I'm so happy. Where is the crew? These guys are the greatest crew ever. Never would have won without this guy. These guys are amazing.
Good job.
Get off this thing and don't look at it for a while.
Oh, yeah.
Hey guys, look over here quick for a second. Just a quick fast one before we get all official. All right. How many five weights have you finished now?
Five.
So next year.
Finally got second, third, and fourth. So now I got 1, 2, 3, 4. You guys are the best.
Dude,
you were here for all of them.
This is it. Oh, get off that thing before you fall over.
Yeah, I have a history of blacking out here. So, I should probably do something. Oh, man.
Awesome.
Yeah. Fall down. Yeah.
That big pile.
Is it working?
Yeah, there we go. Throw me that water.
Okay, I'll put it up on the floor. Yeah. Good job, man.
Thanks, dude. You have the greatest race of the course.
Here, you can sit down and do it here.
This is the greatest course.
Jesse, what was the biggest challenge?
Actually, I'll tell you what it was. It was dialing it back. I was managing my speed. I finally did a good job of managing my speed. Bone Dog just blew by me with authority on stage 5.
Right in the middle of the night.
200 miles to go, I knew he made his move too soon. So I dialed it back. I kept him in sight. I didn't go with him. And then even like on the way to Sheeple, I still dialed it back. I managed my energy because I knew I needed energy for 29 pumps. And usually I just want to go. I've had here, like 2010, I was torched by stage 7, so I went out too fast.
So does that make the difference this year, dialing it back?
Oh, 100%. 100%. Managing the speed was absolutely, I wouldn't be that. For most of it.
So you're in pre league company, Hall of Fame, right? Fifth finish, winner, multiple podium winner. I mean, how does that make you feel?
I'm just so happy. I worked really hard for it. I can show you my mile log for the year. It's pretty crazy.
Places won in training, right?
I mean, I did a 300-mile triple up to Big Bear and back, 22,000 feet of climbing 3 weeks ago. I paid my dues like over and over and over again. I got to the mountains 19 times since February to now.
You just finished a few minutes ago, but maybe it's not too early to ask. Another attempt at the win.
Yeah, oh, I already promised that I wouldn't race next year because my son's going away to college, and, you know, the last thing the family needs is one more year with Dad being gone all the time. But I think I want to come back. I'll just say it. I might do it or might not do it. I want to come back the following year and set the record in the double. So it'd be sacrificing the win on the 508 because I don't think you can race it to win and then go get another one. I'd have to dial it back. But that's what I'm toying with.
Well, here's the glory time.
All right, take your gloves off, dude. I'll give you your medal and jersey.
Right on. All
right.
The doctors are like in bad water.
Right? Kelso, yeah. Well, we are in a town here. The hospital.
You don't have anybody to wake me up.
We got an AED right there. So.
Yeah, I got the Fearless Crew. I'm going to put into my Fearless Crew. These guys just took care of every little detail. This is a full bite.
Right?
Oh, you
just did over here. Fantastic. Well, Sean, your fifth attempt, your first victory, 29 hours, 33 minutes, 10 seconds. Congratulations. The Crow, men's solo champion, 2012, Furnace Creek 508. There's your... Wow. Your medal, and here's your jersey.
Beautiful.
Take that.
Love it.
Handshake.
Thank you, Chris.
Oh, you're welcome.
Congrats, bro. All right, bro. Man,
yeah.
I know, isn't it? You've got to get this.
I mean, I dedicated like 20,000 miles of training to the 508 this year. It's just insane with this guy. How many people this guy has inspired? How many miles were written in the name of the training for the 508?
I know.
It's got to be a million miles.
All right. That's good. I won't get the crew up here. Yeah, I mean, seriously. I mean, just the number of miles ridden during the 508. But then you think about all the miles people do to get here.
Yeah.
I mean, that's astronomically beyond that.
So. Oh, yeah. It's something else.
Well, plus, you know, you've had quite the progression up to winning. But not only that, but you had your big setback. How long ago were you hit by that car?
Well, 2007. I got second. The guys weren't happy, so I got hurt.
Yeah.
2010, I got fourth. Guys weren't happy, so this guy T-boned me in his car. Got my shoulder.
Yep. So two times hit by cars.
So I was out for
5 years.
Yeah. 08-09.
Yeah.
Couldn't make it.
Yeah. Well, it's good to have you back.
Hopefully
all in one piece and in first place.
The gods will take first place and not sitting on a car.
Yeah. Maybe you should just, you know, become a runner for a while. Yeah. Or a swimmer. Then you're totally off the road. Well, let's get your crew on up here.
Crew!
Come on up, guys.
John, Orlando!
Orlando!
John!
What up, everybody?
Oh, my God. These crew guys are celebrating. Champions.
Champions. Here we go. You gotta come this way a little bit.
We got him.
Well, guys. Awesome. Congratulations.
Thanks. Right on.